Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform any regular text into powerful, distressed, grunge text. I provided a Photoshop template that has three layers: a high contrast texture for the inside of our text, a distressed paper texture that we'll use for the background, and a white background that we'll place our regular text onto. I also provided a grungy texture that we'll use as a displacement map to distort our text. The text I'll be using in this video is called Phenomicon Condensed, which I also provided a link to. Feel free to use any text you like, however, to achieve the best results, I find that thick, heavy fonts work the best. Hide the two top layers and make the white background active. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We want black to be our foreground color. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. Pick a font you want to use for this project. I'll make its size 915 points, but feel free to adjust its size based on the font you choose and the number of characters in your text. Make the aliasing smooth. The alignment is irrelevant in this case. Type out your text. Open your Move tool and move it. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as replace our text without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 25 pixels, but again, feel free to adjust any of the amounts I'll be using in this video to better suit your text. Keep in mind, you can adjust them at any time. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Threshold. Dragging the slider to the left or right decreases or increases the thickness of our text. I'll set mine at 75. Make the text layer active and go to Filter, Distort, and Ripple. I'll make the amount minus 45 and the size large. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Displace. I'll make the horizontal and vertical scales 20 each, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Navigate to the displacement texture PSD file I provided and open it. Immediately, our text is full of grungy goodness. To place it onto the distressed paper background, open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the thumbnail of any of the channels to select our text. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Open back the Layers panel and click the top layer. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the selection with black, and since our foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. Make the distressed paper base visible. The displacement map shifted our text up and over based on the amount we typed in earlier, so if you want to reposition it, simply drag it to the center. Lastly, we'll add grungy texture to the inside of our text. Make the inside texture layer visible and active. To confine it to just the inside of our text, hover your cursor between that layer and the text layer and press Alt or Option. When your cursor changes into a clipping mask icon, click it. Another way to do this is to press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac, or you could go to Layer and create clipping mask. By hiding and revealing this clipped layer, we can see the difference. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.